And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. Très bon. Très bien. Very good. And the evening and the morning were the sixth day. Well, that's kind of a summary statement. God saw everything that he had made, and it was very good. Very good. That's quite a testimony, isn't it? That God, that the Creator, the creating agent, whom we're calling Elohim, who refers to himself in the plural, at least at the moment that he's creating man, who is a twosome, he speaks of himself in the plural, let us make man in our image. Is God a male and female? I don't know. He created a creature that was like him, in his image. Not equal to, not the same as, but in his image. We don't know when or how God came about. We don't know if he had a beginning, but man had a beginning. God created man. Therefore, there is an insoluble differentiation between the Creator and that which he has created. They are not the same thing. They are not equal. If that were true, then everything that exists would be equal to God. And that is illogical. It's just illogical. In any case, God assesses all of his work and says that it is good. A world of life which was in need of a surveyor, an arbiter, an arbiter, a controller, a manager, and that was the assignment given to man. Man is responsible for the earth. If we can comprehend that, responsible to take care of the world and everything in it, all the plant forms, all the animal forms, all the life forms. What a glorious assignment. What a magnificent concept of mankind. To have dominion over the entire creation. Made in the image of God. And God saw everything that he had made, and said that this is good, this is very good. I think we should just pause there and meditate a minute, and appreciate what we are part of, however fallen, however deformed, however marred, misshapen, cursed, we're still part of something that is very good. Very good.